We often tend to remind ourselves of our mistakes, and we very little remind ourselves of our successes. Kosovo is a great success story of U.S. foreign policy, and I try to convey this message wherever I go. Everybody is, when you think of, and when they think of interventionism, the only thing they remember is Iraq or Afghanistan, but there's also Kosovo. Kosovo was liberated, and not a single U.S. soldier has lost their life. And when they marched in, for us it was like saints marching in. They were welcomed as heroes. So to me it's very important to emphasize the role that the United States has played in Europe, and how fundamental and crucial it is, not only for Kosovo, but also for the rest of the Balkans. Especially now, considering the increasingly aggressive role that Russia is trying to play. Secondly, Kosovo, although it's peaceful and prosperous, is still unfinished business. Serbia still has not recognized Kosovo, we're still not member of the United Nations, and we are still not member of NATO. And that's our main strategic objective, and this is where United States has a major role to play. Beyond that, the main investments in Kosovo are from American companies. We have a lot of student exchange. Every year, Kosovo brings around 80 students to finish their certificate or master programs in the best of universities here. We have students here at the Missouri University. So there is a lot of exchange and cooperation. But first and foremost, I want to highlight the role that U.S. has played, but also the role that U.S. needs to play in order to complete peace in the Western Balkans.
Okay.
I think there is a massive misunderstanding. People put refugees and migrants on the same category. This is wrong. No one chooses to be a refugee. No one wants to be a refugee. Migrants, they run for a better life. Refugees run for life. So I think we all have a responsibility to open our hearts and to be as helpful as we can. And there are so many ways to help refugees. It's not only about resettling them. There are many NGOs, many organizations that need funds, that need support. And there are so many ways one can be helpful. I try to convey this message as much as I can. The Pope has power to mobilize more than anything else. I've seen it throughout my lifetime, but I also see it today, every day, with young people in Kosovo who are struggling to be part of the global family. One needs to be committed, and one needs to have love and passion for whatever they choose to do. We all can succeed and be good at something. We just need to find out what that something is. And whatever we choose to do, we should do it with honor, with love, and integrity.